And despite what people think, you can absolutely hear the motor.
Yeah, it's got an interesting little whine to it. Huh. Woo!
That'll do. What's up, everyone? I'm here with Karl, and we're meeting up just the day before the State of Charge conference in Denver, Colorado. And we were able to get together, and Karl has this absolutely beautiful Porsche EV conversion, and he's been nice enough to agree to take us through it. So, Karl?
Yeah.
Thanks again.
Thank you. You're welcome.
I mean, just looking at this, the first thing that pops out at me is these wheels. White wheels, red Porsche. Where did you get this car?
It was at my mechanic's backyard for like 15 years.
Okay.
All right. And they were, you know, the shop had changed hands and everything. So nobody knew anything of the history of this car. It got dropped off because something wasn't working. And the owner, the original owners, never came back. Actually, he passed away some years ago. So they just didn't know. It was just sitting there. And I was able to make a deal on it, and for a very, very reasonable price. And it was a rust-free car from New Mexico.
Is this the first Porsche you've ever owned?
No, it's the second one I've had. I had a 914 there for quite a while. That was a lot of fun also.
And this is the 944?
924.
924.
Actually, 924S. This is the last year of that model.
Really?
Yeah, 1988.
And if you look under the hood here, something unique is that there's no motor.
There is no motor.
So what did you do for this conversion as far as the motor that you chose?
Yeah, I just pulled everything out. The intent was to do a fairly budget-friendly conversion. So working with Jimmy at over EV Swap, he turned me on to the Resolve EV controller that works with Nissan Leaf drive systems. And that includes the BMS battery pack, the drives, the charging, the whole nine yards.
Awesome.
So it was like, okay, so that's smart. So just go get a used or a busted car, pull all the parts out, throw it in. So I went with that and found a 2023 Nissan Leaf that only had 8,000 miles on it, had the big motor, the big battery pack. And we picked that up better than a year ago, and just pulled everything out and just figured out how to shove it in this.
So what are we looking at here?
So that's the front battery box.
That's front battery box.
So yeah, got front battery box, relay system here for the high voltage relays and everything. BMS is in the back side of this.
Okay.
And then where the back seat was is the other half of the battery pack. So everything connects between them.
Okay.
Right. And then, yeah, a little upgrades to a Tesla power steering or power braking system.
Have a power steering Tesla system. Brakes.
Tesla brakes.
I'd never seen that on a conversion before. People reusing the Tesla system. That's awesome.
I tell you what, that's one of the best things I put on here because now I got some really good brakes. This thing's great. I did rebuild the factory calipers and brake system and everything like that. Made sure it was all good. And believe me, that makes a big difference. That just stops the car.
Awesome. And then you have some suspension work done here too.
I did. After I got the back battery box in, because of the weight. So the raw batteries were over 700 pounds.
Wow.
For just the modules. So then I did everything, basically just angle iron, you know, welding and stuff for the boxes. Got the back box in, and we ended up with about a 60 weight to 40 to the front compared to the 50-50 the car was originally. So when I did drive the first drive on it, it was sagging in the back pretty good with the old suspension, not great.
Interesting.
You know? So I ended up going for it, putting fully adjustable coilovers, got a hold of a company in California that set me up with Swiss springs. They looked at my weights because I gave them all the weights for the different corners. They set me up with the right springs and the whole nine yards, bolted it in. This thing's rocking. This thing is so solid to drive. It's so much fun.
Did you tell them it was an EV, or were they like, yep, what are these weights?
Yep.
Why is it so heavy in the back?
Exactly. And they were like, cool, this is neat. We've never done one, you know, kind of thing.
Totally.
It worked out great, but it was, they made the right set of suspension that worked on this car. I had to remove the torsion bars and everything that came with the original Porsche car, and then put that in. It was like, tune it up, adjust them, and off we went. It was really quite simple.
So let's look at that second battery pack.
Yeah. So it's taken up what used to be, not that there was much of a back back seat in it, but
It's right tucked under there.
It's tucked under there. I just had some carpet made for it. So we have four of the largest modules across the back here where the back seat was, and then four of the smallest modules on top of where the motor is.
And do you retain the transmission?
Nope.
For this one?
This is all Nissan drive. So the Nissan has an 8-to-1 reduction gear, and then set up for axles. And then I just basically merged the two between the Nissan axles and the Porsche axles.
And awesome.
Bought some more heavy duty CVs for the Porsche and stuff, and had a good shop welded all together. And it works. There's no vibration. This thing just takes off.
How many miles have you put on it since it's been built?
I have got, something about not quite 1,500.
Okay.
All right.
Trouble-free?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, it's great. Plug it in at home, go drive around.
So I have a question.
Sure.
Can we drive it around?
Sure.
Could we go on a ride?
Absolutely.
Awesome. Let's do it.
All right. Cool.
All right. This is my first time being in a 924 Porsche. And so far, I love it.
So no air conditioning, but heating's coming. So that's on the docket next. Hopefully heated seats, because I'm gonna have these reupholstered.
It feels like a sports car.
Oh yeah.
You're sit in it like a sports car.
All push button, no more shifting. Shifter was here.
And despite what people think, you can absolutely hear the motor.
Yeah, it's got an interesting little whine to it. Huh. Woo!
That'll do.
That's half the fun, is just that quick acceleration and stuff.
The instant torque.
The instant torque, that's just the kick of it all. So if you need to get out of the way, you can do it pretty quickly.
So what you're saying is that EVs is a safety mod. So you need high horsepower EVs to be safe on the highway.
My dad always got cars with great big engines in them just to get out of the way of stuff. And it's like, well, that got me in trouble when I was 16. But this thing here is just fun. You don't have to drive it hard, you just drive it. And it's just really a comfortable car.
There's plenty of leg room, plenty of headroom.
Yep.
And you drove this to Colorado from your house several hundred miles away, right?
Yeah, Taos, New Mexico.
And just public charging the whole way?
Yep. Yep.
No, didn't run into any dead chargers or any of that stuff?
No, I only had it charged twice, so it wasn't too bad.
So range-wise, you said you were getting around 120 miles on the highway.
The first time. Actually, I'm good for about 200.
During around town, does it give you a little bit better?
A little better, because you're not, pushing it up the freeway at 80 miles an hour.
Sure.
But it'll do it just fine. So, not a problem on that. So, But it's just kind of a kick.
It's got that kick. I can feel the acceleration. You can really feel the difference in the suspension too. It hugs the road.
Oh yeah, it's
quite
nice
a lot.
Suspension. Yep.
And it just keeps pulling.
Yeah. Yeah, and I've even got a little bit of regen on, so it will slow itself down a little bit. Otherwise, you can just coast, or you can add more regen and literally use it as one pedal driving.
So you actually have adjustability on that. That's great.
Quite a bit. So it's still learning a lot of it, but it's, pretty good.
Have you gone through any sets of tires?
No, this is the first set.
Still the first set.
Yeah, yeah. I've only had it driving since mid-January, and then I think I've only had the set of wheels and tires on it for maybe a couple of months once I got it all set up, maybe a little bit more.
Looks absolutely gorgeous. It's a very clean conversion, Karl.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah, I like the interior and the dash. It still has that kind of classic feel, but yet you have your modern gauges that you need, your state of charge.
Yeah, that was the oil pressure gauge, and I just repurposed it for that. So yeah, it worked out good. See if I can find my way back. Oh, it's around here. So, but yeah, I found a 12-volt gauge over in Europe. They sent it to me, and then repaired the clock on it so it actually works. And just tried to make everything back the way it was as much as I could.
It's tasteful, tasteful upgrades.
Thank you. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Let's keep it. New steering wheel. I didn't like the old one. It was a little hard.
I think that the rubber gets hard over the years.
Oh yeah,
right?
It's skinny. You know.
Yeah, yeah.
So I found a deal on the Momo, put it on.
Got the Momo steering wheel and the suspension upgrades. Have you taken this to the track yet?
Oh, no.
No?
Nope. I've not raced it. I'm not qualified probably for that yet, so I don't know.
maybe a drag racing day or
could
something
fun,
like that.
Could be fun, yeah. Actually, just drag people on the streets. That's all fun.
Do you have a rough idea what the 0-60 is on it?
Right around 5.
Right around 5?
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah. Yeah. So you feel it.
Yeah.
You feel it. Yeah. It's kind of cool.
That way. Does this go up?
Oh, it's okay. We'll leave it.
What's the donor for that?
924.
What's that?
924.
What's the donor?
Oh, a Leaf.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right on. I'm on my third Tesla, so I heard it go and I was like, all right, they did something.
Yeah, yeah.
Right on, nice.
Thank you.
Wait, we're good.
Yeah, so trying to get everything working on the car as it was, as best as I can. So, you know, restoring it a little as we go. That's, like I said, the original paint, so we haven't done anything with that. Just buffed it out.
How big are these tires that you have on there? Those are proper.
I went to 17s, and that's a 9-inch wide tire.
17?
9-inch, the rears are 9, and the fronts are 7s.
Awesome.
So the tire size is pretty much what the stock tire size was.
Okay.
Try not to mess it up too much that way.
It's really clean, Karl.
To work. Well, thank you.
I like this a lot. And now I'm a 924 fan.
Oh, good. Good, yeah.
Thank you so much for the ride. What's next for this build, other than just the little tweaks,
just
or do you have another
build? Really? No, I don't have another car yet. You know, I have a garage and a half where all my tools are. It's all by myself. In Taos, nobody's doing anything, so not like this.
So you just can enjoy the car now.
Can enjoy it.
Yeah. Awesome. Well, thank you, sir.
You're welcome.